Okay, guys, spot number two. We're at the Bedford Skate Park in Bedford, New Hampshire. And we're gonna do some stuff.
I found change.
And we're gonna get some clips. You know what I'm saying? Okay, spot number two. We're at the Bedford Skate Park now in Bedford, New Hampshire. Still with Vinny. We're gonna hit some stuff, do some tricks. Yeah.
So, it is the 16th of April, but on the 18th, it will be exactly 1 year after we have uploaded Webisode 1, which will be the 1 year anniversary of White Earth BMX. So, we are going to do a year in summary. Webisode 1 sucked. Wouldn't you agree?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. We fell onto this YouTube channel together. We woke up. He slept over the previous night. It was our first time ever hanging out. And I was like, let's ride to the Inside Scoop and film a video. And I had no idea that we were going to post it on YouTube. We filmed it and came here, as you saw in that video. Now we're at the Bedford Skate Park. That's exactly where we filmed it. And from there, we edited it crappily. We sucked completely. And we uploaded it. And I said two things to Vinny. I said, so much shit for this, which we did. Two, we're gonna look back on this a year later and say that we sucked, which we also did. So that is important because we have just improved so much, and I probably would not have improved. We're not in the circle shirt. Probably wouldn't have improved so much if we weren't filming it, and we wouldn't have noticed our improvement if we weren't filming it. Well, we also would have tolerated scooter kids if we didn't film it. We have gotten better at it, and we've improved a lot. And this is just important because, yeah, well, Patrick has started to. And, as the year's gone on, we have filmed a lot of videos. We filmed bike checks, edits, which kind of sucked. Yeah, that's kind of sucked. We have filmed texting. Alt Siri. Stacy Nichols. Okay. We filmed tutorial. That's our highest viewed video. Webisodes are my favorite. This is going to be Webisode 10. 10 webisodes, 1 year. I'm actually really happy about the 1 year anniversary. Because it's not an introduction, we're telling the story.
Patrick, you're just retarded.
Yeah.
In like every way possible.
White Rice BMX is our life, practically. We have pretty much changed from basketball players and hockey players and people who do nothing with their lives at all. We have changed our own lives, Patrick.
Except for you, Patrick.
Who cares? You'd probably make the video's IQ go down.
You don't even know how to do
and that, so it's okay. We have become complete BMXers all day, every day. Vinny, you're not allowed to leave here.
What?
We see you escaping. Ah, no!
I end my life here.
Well, now we just lost a character. And so, we have come a long way and turned into complete skaters. I even got an earring yesterday, all right? Piercings. My ear doesn't even hurt, though. That's good. But yeah, so, thanks for watching our videos and giving a shit, because without it, we'd probably just be nobodies still. We're nobodies at school, but we mean something at Rye. Rye Airfield is the best place ever. I just want to talk for longer now because, you know. Well, so now we're going to jump into a lot of clips. And, oh yeah, we also made t-shirts. I have not showed a t-shirt in the video. Vinny, come over here. You're our model. You're our sexy model.
I am sexy.
Get over here. Get closer. So they say White Earth BMX on them. And we have a few left, so we lower the price. Please buy them so I can make better ones, because those are crap. They're not crappy, like, they just don't have much design on them, but the fabric's super soft, and it's a moisture-wicking fabric, so when you're riding, it doesn't look like you have a sweat puddle on your ass. So, yeah. Like, look at Vinny, he's the sweatiest person I know, and he doesn't have any sweat visible on his shirt. And he does not spray antiperspirant on himself to model. I said you don't! Oh, wait a second, that makes you seem like you don't shower either.
Oh, that's bad.
Well, anyways, this is a 5-minute run-on clip now. So, just enjoy the rest of the video and us riding. We were gonna go to Inside Scoop, but we were too lazy.
Harrison, look at it. Patrick, go right in front of Harrison.
Patrick, come over here. Okay then. So yeah, thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. And the video's not over yet because we're gonna keep filming clips. Yeah.
Trip number one. That one.
Okay, so I'm gonna do the same thing Vinny just did. He's gonna go off that launch ramp.
Okie dokie. I'm going to hit this launch ramp. And when I edit, I'm gonna put it in slow-mo because I'm a super cool bike rider dude, okay? Bam! Let's do it! Oh my god! Insane! Pink clinks.
Peg clinks.
Parkour, dudes. Dudes, you like me parkouring? My new YouTube channel, it's called Patrick Parkourin. We're going on an adventure. Going on an adventure.
Oh yeah, I know what you're talking about, Harrison. Ew, there's dirty underwear.
I think somebody had sex under there.
Trying to fake it?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were just gonna go up, turn, and go down.
Oh. Why are you still falling?
Dude, do something. Just go in a line. Right?
Leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Let's see you do a peg chink.
Oh, crap. Take that out.
No.
Take that out.
No.
That was awful. Take that out. Nobody likes you. He's got an earring.
Yeah, we already told him that. This is the second place we've been. Oh!
That was cool.
Alright, so I have done a bike check over the past year, so I'm going to do a bike check now in honor of 1 year of YEAR OF WR BMX. Now, this started out as a 2016 Sabroso Leadum Complete. There is almost no original parts left on this bike. Because I am stupid. First thing.
You got that right.
That I have is the Sabroso 2016 Leadum frame. Now let's go into the forks. Standard Sabroso forks. Rant pegs to match my rant from hub
with hub guards. They come with the hub.
Why'd you get a new hub?
Shout out to...
I'll explain it
when I get to the back. I have these tires. They're called Sabrosis Drive Nuovas. They're really good. They're grippy. They have 110 PSI, which I love, because it's almost impossible to pop them. Now let's move up here. We got a Rant headset. Premium Sub V10 front load stem. Now, I like my bars up, but I couldn't find a top load stem at Goodale's because I was too lazy to look. So I got this and turned it upside down. Alrighty? Next, the handlebars. They have premium handlebars, as seen on my old bike. Black ODI super soft grips. Those are the best grips. Don't even argue, alright? Next up, pedals. They're the Mission Green pedals. They're really, really good. They're the plastic ones. They're insanely grippy. They're too grippy right after you get them, actually. That's why you have to wear them in a little bit. So yeah, grind on them a lot, and they're just awesome. Next, my crank. They're one of the very few standard parts in this bike. The ramp cranks. And then, going over here, we have KMC chrome chain, Sabrosa brand shred sprocket. And then the back, that's where, if you see the front hub is chrome, black hub is black. The hub guard was aluminum that came with it originally, the original hub. And it was so flexible because it was aluminum that it bent and started hitting my spokes. So I took it off, and the first grind I did, it literally, there's like a little cone nut in there. And it compressed down so tight on the bearing that it ruined the whole hub. And I thought I bent my axle, so I started hitting it with a hammer and just ruined the whole entire wheel. So I got this new Salt Plus wheel. It's really great. You know, the spokes stay really tight. I can't even make any noise. Same tires in the front.
Excuse me.
Ramp pegs, Salt Plus hub guard came with it. If your wheels do not come with hub guards, then you have a big issue because they're supposed to, because hub guards are so specific. I have a Shadow Conspiracy.
I don't have hub guards.
Clamp. Well, yeah, it's all right, though. It's your Patrick. And then I have a Sabrosa denim seat, you know. It's really, really nice. And now, let me see this. Now, for all these things, go to Goodale's Bike Shop in Hooksett, New Hampshire.
Or Second
Center sucks. Goodale's Bike Shop, absolute best. Sabrosa is a good brand. White Rice BMX, that's a sticker right there. Go subscribe. Shout out to us for the 1 year anniversary.
So we got here the Haro Downtown Deluxe version. The only thing that I changed is these super soft ODI grips, and there's a Walmart tube inside.
After your whole bike check, you're not going to call all the parts you have on there?
I've never changed anything.
Well, why don't you just read off the parts? I said that you should just tell them what you have so they can copy individual parts.
All right. Got this crappy ass fork, two nipples, because I had front brakes on
it. Like a girl?
And I got these. My frame was actually bent. Now it's not bent anymore.
Thanks to me.
You didn't do anything.
Yeah, I did.
And I got these pedals. They're a big piece of plastic. And we got a sticker. It says, not for sale.
Sexy.
And is there, and this part is different from the original part. See, Vinny took off all my gyro brakes, and then my dad got really mad, and we had to take it to the bike shop, and it was a lot of money. It wasn't that much money, but Vinny sold it.
He breaks everything. All right. Hole right here. Is it blood me? I just got blood me. Hi there. Hello. I like chicken. All right, so this is my bike. It is a We the People versus Complete. It's pretty nice. Yeah. It's pretty great. Yeah. It's got eclat / pedals, some Salt Plus cranks, Salt Plus PC pedals, some PC hub guards, Demolition machete tires, just a Salt cassette hub and rim. Sounds pretty great. Some random chain sprocket that comes on it. Demolition machete tire in the front too.
We the People pivotal seat. Some We the People bars, Salt Plus grips. I don't know what they are. Salt Plus stem. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Yeah. It's also got stickers.
Yeah, you put a lot of stickers on it, you know?
It's only like five.
Yeah, so it's not broken, even though I threw it down the stairs in the last video by accident. Yeah. That was an accident.
Cut to the clip now.
Sick. We are going to film the how-to for this video, how to double peg. And I'm going to teach you. So yeah. Don't do that! That is a demonstration. I wish there was something taller here, but there isn't, so.
Let's do the down row.
Do the down row?
Yeah.
So, the thing about double pegs, is everyone thinks you're gonna go straight into it? But, so, what you need to learn how to do, top to the side, all right? Because what you do is you come actually parallel to it, right? And that's why you like longer stuff to wear.
Get that perfect angle on top so you can see. Let me put this closer. Okay, we found it back, okay.
Pretty much what you do is you come up to it and you hop side, boom! Like that. So, you need to learn how to hop to the side. So the best way to learn how to hop to the side is like find like a big crack or a line if you're in your garage or something and just hop over it to the side that you grind. If you're not like messed up footed or anything, I'm not gonna say the F word because my mom watches these videos. Shout out to my mom. If I'm right foot forward, so if I grind on the right. If you're like Vinny and your left foot forward, you'll grind on the left. So you'll have to hop to the left if you're left foot forward. And hop to the right if you're right foot forward. Alright? This skate park is falling apart. So as you can see, there's a big crack. And I'm gonna demonstrate how you can learn how the double peg. The first step is up. So what pretty much you're gonna do is just ride parallel to it and hop over it.
Bam, I'm gonna take you down.
So just practice that. Do that like 10 times. When you're feeling really comfortable with it, you'll find something to grind. So this is actually meant for skateboards, this thing. But I'm just gonna show you doing it on a bike because I don't feel like going all the way home to just film this. So this one, you only have to hop about an inch, which I always say is pristine for learning, because you're probably not very confident with your over-hopping yet. You're probably more comfortable going sideways than hopping high. So what you pretty much just want to do is you're going to want to ride parallel to it, like I said, and then just hop on the side. And you're following to it. Now, this is not last, but it's not very well. But as you see, I just hop over the side. And at the end, if you go right, you just want to do like a manual a little bit and pull up out of it. Like that. And now you know how to double peg.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Is it going?
Yeah.
Stop it.